Hello guys, welcome for another Piqué card reading, and today we're going to ask the question, what does your person like and dislike about you? We have three groups. Group one, so delight. Group number two, blue kyanite. And finally, we have celestite for group number three. So there you go. You may simply pause the video if you need some additional time. And again, not everything will resonate because this is a general reading. Hello, group number one, you chose soda light crystal. Let's find out, what does your person like and dislike about you? Spirit guides, archangels, and angels, please provide some guided messages for the collective who chose group number one. First card you got here, Eight of Wands. You have the Empress. Wow. Okay. You have Four of Pentacles. You have Ten of Pentacles. You have the Hangman. And the last card, wow, you got here, Strength. At the bottom of the deck, you have King of Wands. So I'm actually seeing here a lot of fire energies, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, especially Leo. Also Earth, Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus, especially Taurus. I'm also seeing here Pisces, if it's actually water, and Libra, if it's air. So, what does your person like and dislike about you? Let's start off with what they like about you, okay? Right off the bat, what I actually also heard is that they love the instant attraction that they have with you, okay? Maybe the first time that you guys met. They love the instant attraction. You're very magnetic. You're very charming. That's what they like about you. Whether you're male or female watching this, they find you so freaking beautiful or very attractive. Let's just put it that way, okay? They also love the fact that you are very nurturing, you're very loving, and you're very, very generous. Some of you guys are actually already a parent. That's also what I'm picking up because I'm drawn to this card over here, where it shows a wolf with small babies over here or around this mama wolf, okay? So I'm actually getting that some of you are already a mom or a dad. And what they actually like about you is that you are very hands-on, okay? You're very supportive to your kid or your kids. You're very loving. That's what they like about you. They also like the fact that you are a go-getter, all right? You are an achiever, basically. You have high hopes and dreams for yourself. You really know who you are and who you aren't. And when you want something, you're actually very, very determined. Although what I'm picking up, and this is for some of you, what they don't like about you is that you can be a little bit stubborn. You're very fixed. Sometimes it's hard for you to bend your ways. It's like my way or the highway. That's also what I'm picking up for others of you, okay? And I'm also hearing what they also don't like about you is that you're very impatient, okay? You want something now. Like, if you want something, you wanted to get it now, fast. And I'm hearing somebody saying they don't like that you can be a little bit demanding. Okay, so only take what resonates and don't shoot the messenger, because I'm just going to deliver whatever it is that I'm hearing right now. For others of you, I'm actually hearing that what they don't like about you is that you're resistant to change. So you're not bendable, you're not flexible, okay? But they also like the fact that you also try to analyze the situation from a higher perspective, where you're open to seeing things, actually, for others of you. You're open to seeing things from a higher perspective. But for others of you, they don't like the fact that you are stubborn or that you're resistant to change and that you can be a little bit bossy or demanding. Okay, but they also love the fact that you're a very, very strong person with this strength card, okay? You're very strong, you're very dominant, okay? You're actually possessing the strong leadership skills as well. That's what they like about you. But for others of you, I'm actually also hearing something about aggression. So, or being assertive as well. Aggression and assertive. I don't know why I'm hearing those two words, but yeah, that's also what they like and don't like about you. Can be assertive, but sometimes you're actually way too fast, or I'm hearing like very, very aggressive in a not so good way. Okay, that's also what I'm picking up. But they also see you as somebody who is actually very family oriented. That's what they like about you. You value your family, you value your kids. If you're already a parent, your kids are very much important to you, and that's what they like about you. You're very protective as well of your family. You will do basically everything for your family, whether this is your own family or your immediate family. All right, I'm not hearing anything else. Let's try to put more. What does your person like and dislike about you? Group number one. You have message in a bottle. Ooh, never ending story. Okay. All right. And you got your new life. Okay. But yeah, they actually see you as a soulmate. Let me actually add that, because that's at the bottom of the deck. All right, so what they like about you, let's start off with that. They like the fact that they resonate so much with you. You're also a friend to them, okay? Because this is about a romantic partner, okay? So you're also a friend to them, not just a lover. They can really open up to you, and that there are so many things that you guys can resonate with each other. You vibe so well, okay? You've opened up this person's heart as well. They feel so comfortable with you. They can lean on you just like these two penguins over here. They also like the fact that you're very loyal, okay? Because penguins are actually very, very loyal. So that's what they really, really like about you. What they don't like about you is that I'm drawn to this never-ending story, okay? Never-ending story talks about wounded ego, okay? It also talks about dramas. So that's what they don't like about you, about the dramas, the never-ending dramas, or the conflicts, being the victim, or victim blaming as well. It can also be that. So that's actually one of the things that they don't like. Maybe when you guys get into a heated argument, you probably bring up some stuff from the past as well, instead of moving on from that. That's also what I'm hearing right now. That's what they don't like about you, okay? You can be overly emotional when you're upset or when you're mad. That's also what I'm hearing right now. That's the one thing as well that they don't like about you. I'm also picking up that what they like about you is that you are very loving though, okay? You're just really, really loving, and you would really, you know, tell the people that you care about how much you value them, okay? So you're very demonstrative. That's what they like about you. But then again, I'm drawn to this never-ending story. So again, they're really saying that they don't like the fact that it can be a little bit dramatic, okay? It can be very emotional, all right? Especially when you're mad or upset, or you tend to bring up the past all the time, or you always see yourself as a victim. I'm also hearing for others of you, they don't like the fact, which is weird because I'm getting more of like a confident person for others of you. But since this is a general reading, I'm picking up a small portion of you in which they don't like the fact that you don't believe in yourself. You always see yourself as a victim, or that you're pitiful. Okay. That's what they don't like about you. All right. Let's see what else. what does your person like and dislike about you? All right, you got your patience. You have harmony. You have hope. At the bottom of the deck, you have here financial and material changes. So I'm getting a mixture of energies and messages. Let's start off with patience. For others of you, yes, you're a very patient person. Okay, that's what they really like about you. You're very patient. Maybe you've been waiting for this person for so long as well. That's what I'm hearing. And they know that. They are aware how patient you are with the situation, especially if this is actually a third party situation, because I'm also getting that. The others of you are actually dealing with a person who's already married with kids. Okay, that's also what I'm getting. They see you as somebody who's actually not rushing into things. All right, you're just really patient in achieving your goals. That's also what I'm hearing. You're very optimistic. You're very positive. But for others of you, I'm also hearing that you're not patient, because that's also what I heard at the very beginning, that you want something, you want it now. You can be a little bit, you know, demanding. That's actually what I heard earlier, okay? So I'm getting a mixture of energies here. Only take what resonates. With this harmony, I feel some of you guys are dealing with Taurus, by the way, and Gemini. That's actually what I'm hearing very strongly right now. And with this harmony card, they really, you know, like the fact that you're actually very, again, romantic, very loving. And they love the fact that you make them feel at home or at peace. That's what they like about you, all right? And you always give them hope as well. You probably are a good motivator, you know? Like, you motivate them, you encourage them. That's actually what they like about you. For others of you, I'm actually getting with this financial material changes, this is actually talking about lack as well. So I feel that what they don't like about you is that sometimes you tend to always dwell or look into the things that you actually currently do not have, okay? Especially when you're actually in that never-ending story energy in which you're always, you know, seeing yourself as a pitiful creature. I don't have this, I don't have that, or poor me. I'm also getting that for a small portion of you, okay? But for others of you, yes, they see you as a very patient, very loving, very nurturing, kind person. And they just love the fact that you're still waiting, actually. That's what I'm hearing. They know that you're actually waiting for them and that you're staying hopeful and optimistic about the situation. Okay, I'm not hearing anything else. Let's see. The number 5 kept on popping up, so maybe the number 5 is going to be of significance for some of you. Let's try this deck. What does your person like and dislike about you? You have nature, Gaia. Oh, you got birth, babies. And you got renewal, rebirth. So I'm actually getting Scorpio for others of you. All right, so what do they like about you? I'm actually getting here with this card. So again, I'm getting drama. Honestly, we'll get to the dislike, but what they like about you is that you're very sensitive as well to the emotions of others, okay? You're sensitive to the feelings of others. You're actually very empathic as well. That's what I'm picking up. They also like your eyes. That's also what I'm getting with this card. You may have blue eyes as well. They love your eyes. But sometimes, you know, you can be a little bit dramatic or way too emotional because this is a woman crying. But they also like the fact that you're very protective of the ones that you love, okay? Now, with the birth and babies, this is all about vulnerability. So sometimes it can be, you know, really vulnerable or, again, emotional. That's actually what I'm getting very strongly. But, again, they see you as somebody who's very nurturing, okay? you're very loving, especially to your kids, especially if you're already a parent watching this. You're very loving and protective of your kids. That's what they love about you. You're very gentle, just like the rabbit over here, or the two rabbits over here. Very gentle, very sweet. And they also like the fact that you are a responsible person, okay? That's actually what I'm getting. Although you can be a little bit all over the place or very much overwhelmed, you know, when a lot of things have been going on, all right? You tend to become way too overwhelmed or, yeah, by responsibility maybe, or by a lot of things. With this renewal and rebirth, I'm actually getting that what they like about you is that you have the ability to discard anything that is actually no longer good for your space, okay? Because like what I said, for others of you, you know who you are, you know who you aren't, you know what you want and what is no longer good for you. And you have the ability to basically let go or discard anything that is not good for you anymore. So you're open to changes as well. But for others of you, I'm getting that you're not. So I'm getting mixture of energies here, all right? So only take what resonates, because this is a general reading, because for a small portion of you as well, that's what I'm hearing. What your person doesn't like about you is that you're not open to changes. You're actually in this energy of feeling like you're stuck, or you're putting your attention or your focus on the things that already happened in the past, and instead of moving forward, you keep on going back to the past. That's also what they don't like about you, okay? All right, let's see, what else? And again, number five, there's something about number five, guys, so pay attention to number five. What does your person like and dislike about you? Ooh, you got your soul cage. You have sisterhood. And you got your time out. Okay. At the bottom of the deck, wow, they really find you so beautiful. Let me grab that, because that's what I actually picked up at the very beginning of the reading, that your person is saying they were instantly attracted to your beauty, okay? Whether you're male or female watching this, they really find you so freaking attractive. That's why you are the Empress, okay? So I'm actually picking up that what they like about you is that you're also a good friend. Again, I already mentioned that, because this sisterhood is actually talking about friendship, being allies. So you and your person are actually not only like lovers or lovers, but you're like friends at the same time. And they love that you guys resonate so much with each other, because you got your compatible soul. So they really can resonate so much with you. They can vibe so much with you. You fill this person with a lot of joy or happiness, okay? And they also see you as somebody's very, very loyal, because this card is also about loyalty. Now, with the soul cage, I also feel, now this is for the things that they don't like, okay? That's what I'm hearing right now from spirit. Some of you guys, you feel as if you're actually trapped in a situation, or you tend not to, you know, look at the brighter side of things. That's also what I'm getting for others of you, because somebody's really saying that you tend to go back always to the past. You keep on dwelling on the past. You keep on bringing up the past. So instead of actually moving on from that, all right, you keep on kind of like sinking down into the dark pit or the dark shadows. And that's what they don't like about you. I also feel that yeah, I'm hearing right now that some of you, this person or the person that you have in mind, they don't like the fact that you see yourself as helpless, all right? Or that there is actually no hope in the situation for others of you again, okay? So I'm getting a mixture of messages or energies here. With the timeout for others of you, I'm actually picking up that what they like about you is that you know how to take some time for yourself to recharge, all right? When you're overwhelmed by something, by a lot of responsibility or a lot of things that are actually way too heavy, you know how to take a timeout to balance your energies. That's what they like about you. However, I'm actually hearing someone saying right now, this is very specific. Okay, it's not going to resonate for all of you, but I need to deliver this message. I'm actually hearing someone saying that when you're actually upset or really overwhelmed by something, this person doesn't like the fact that you are kind of like incommunicado. That's actually what I'm hearing right now, that you tend to kind of like detach. And it's like everybody was, you know, worried about what's going on with group number one. What's going on? Are they okay? Have you heard from group number one? I don't know. I'm hearing that very strongly. So you tend to kind of like retreat or detach, and it's like even your family doesn't know where the hell you are. That's actually what I'm hearing right now. That's what they don't like about you, okay? That you tend to just really detach or be in the hermit mode, and it's like they don't know. All right, they don't know what's going on with you. That's actually what I'm hearing very strongly right now. It's not going to resonate for all of you, but somebody needed to hear that. And the number 41 kept on popping up, by the way. I don't know why, but if you add 41, that's 5 again. So you keep on getting the number 5. Remember, I also heard that at the very beginning, that one of the things that this person doesn't like about you is that you're resistant to changes. And number 5 is all about changes as well. So only take what resonates, because I'm also getting some of you are actually, you know, able to adapt to changes. But for others of you with a never-ending story energy, you're feeling stuck. Like you always see yourself as a victim. Like poor me, you keep on going back to the past. And that's what they don't like about you, okay? But all in all, they really love your grace. They love how beautiful you are, whether you're male or female watching this. They also love your hair, because I noticed that they're highlighting the hair over here, okay? So, yeah. Maybe you have very, very beautiful hair as well. And very beautiful eyes. Very expressive eyes, okay? So let's see. What else? What does your person like and dislike about you? Group number one. You have here saboteur. You have thief. Ooh, you have mystic. Okay. And then he got here alchemist. All right, so what does your person like and dislike about you? What your person like about you is that sometimes, you know, let's start off with a like first. They love the fact that you are actually, you know, very smart. You're very creative. You're actually very, very talented, okay? There's a lot of potential within you, okay? You have original ideas as well. That's actually what I'm picking up very strongly on this spread. They're also seeing you as somebody who's actually very intriguing. That's what they like about you. You're very intriguing. You're actually mysterious as well. That's also what I'm picking up. However, when it comes to the things that they don't like about you, is that sometimes, again, when you're actually, you know, not in your good self, you tend to kind of like be in this self-destructive behavior. That's also what I'm picking up. All right. I also feel that some of them, they also see you, or they don't like the fact that, again, you just tend to retreat, or it's hard for you to open up at times when you're hurt, okay? That's actually what I'm picking up very strongly. They see you sometimes as being detached. That's also what I'm hearing very strongly right now from Spirit. Another thing that they also like about you is that, again, you're very knowledgeable. You're a very powerful manifester with this alchemist over here. So there's a lot of things that you can actually do. And they know that you're multi-talented or very much skilled. You actually are able to basically put your plans into, you know, into reality, or you kind of like, you know, have those dreams of yours coming to fruition, or you're able to, you know, get those dreams or plans and ideas be materialized. That's actually what I'm picking up. But other than that, the only thing that they just don't like about you is that sometimes when you're overburdened or overwhelmed by something, okay, when you're stressed out, you tend to be in a self-destructive mode, okay? That's also what I'm getting. Or you tend to detach. All right, let's see, what else? What does your person like and dislike about you? Group number one. You have blossoming abundance. You have ebb and flow. You got your party. You have choice. You have nine of hearts. Next, you got here, trust yourself. And then you have, let's see here, this is the last deck. Okay, yeah, free yourself. Okay, so what I'm actually getting here, what your person likes about you, let's start off with the likes. They love the fact that, again, you are a successful person. You're very skilled. You have a lot of potential. You're very abundant. Now, abundance doesn't necessarily mean just material wealth, okay? You can be abundant in many ways, all right? So they're really seeing you as somebody who's very abundant because of your skills, your talents, your gifts, the many things they can actually do, all right? They also like the fact that you're fun to be with the party. You may be a person who likes to hang out with friends, have a good time with friends. That's what they like about you. They're saying that it's so fun being around you. You fill them with a lot of, joy and delight. That's actually what I'm getting. And I also feel that what they like about you is that for others of you, because I'm also getting for others of you, it's the opposite. But for others of you, just like what I said, you know what you want with this choice, okay? And you're not going to hesitate to decide or to free yourself from something that is actually not good for you, okay? You know what you want, you know what you deserve, and you know what's best for you. So if something is actually not good for you any longer, you're going to discard that, okay? That's why I got the renewal card earlier. However, for others of you, okay, what they don't like about you is that sometimes you're actually, again, you keep on coming back to the past. You keep on dwelling on the past instead of just riding the waves. And I'm actually getting with this ebb and flow, I'm hearing control, okay? It's like you're controlling everything. You're controlling what's about to happen, or you wanted to be in control of the things all the time. And you cannot be in control on life's events, right? On everything that is happening. So that's also one of the things that they don't like about you. And I'm also getting that they don't like the fact that, again, there's something about control, because this is also about control. Maybe some of them, they feel as if they're smothered, all right? Or they feel restricted, okay? Because, again, you wanted to be in control of the situation. That's what they really don't like about you, for others of you, okay? And then another thing that I'm actually hearing right now, this is for a very small portion of you. Although I don't read reversals, but this came out in reverse, and that's actually what I heard from Spirit. Some of you guys have low self-esteem. That's why the never-ending story card popped up. So you think less of yourself. You always see yourself as a victim. Oh, poor me, or pitiful me. I'm actually getting that for others of you. So they're actually saying that what they don't like about you is that you don't trust yourself. You don't trust in your abilities. So that's also another thing that they just don't like about you, because they're saying you have a lot of skill, you have a lot of potential, you have the power, you have a choice, basically. You have a choice to choose things differently or to do something about the situation or about yourself. You're free to choose. You're free to decide. If you don't want something, you can do something about it, all right? The key is in your hands. That's actually what I'm hearing for others of you. So yeah, only take what resonates, all right? Because this is a, you know, general reading, a lot of energies, a lot of scenarios here. But all in all, you fill this person with a lot of peace as well. You make them feel at peace. You make them feel at home. They also like the fact that you're really, really protective. Although for others of you, they don't like that sometimes you're overly protective. That is quite smothering. Okay, that's really what I'm hearing. That's why with this free yourself card, it's like this person felt restricted, or they can't move, or they can't do something because they feel bound. I don't know why I'm getting that for someone out there, but yeah, those are the things that they actually like and dislike about you. Before we wrap things up, I'm actually going to pull up just a random message for you guys. Let me actually pull up my spirit oracle deck. Let's see. Message for group one, please. Okay. You have here ancient knowledge. So this is just a random message. Not everyone will resonate with the message, but this is something that you needed to hear as well. It says here, there is a flame inside your heart, a light that stems from the dawn of time. Ancient love and ancient knowledge are being rekindled. Ooh. Close your eyes, connect with, and feel the loving wisdom you hold. Let it flow out from your heart and transform your life. Well, you have a transformation card, or kind of like a transformation because of the renewal rebirth. So yeah. Let it flow out from your heart and transform your life. Okay, so there you go. That's the message for you, group number one. I hope you enjoyed this reading, and I will see you again on the next Pick a Card. Love and light. Bye-bye, guys. Okay, group number two. You chose blue kyanite. So let's find out. What do they like and don't like about you? Spirit guides, archangels, and angels, please provide some guided messages. For the collective, we chose group number two. You have here Page of Wands. You have Seven of Pentacles. You have Four of Pentacles. You have the High Priestess. Ooh. Okay. Interesting. Next, you got your Queen of Wands. You have Five of Swords, okay. And at the bottom of the deck, you have here Eight of Pentacles. A lot of earth energies, Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus, also fire, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, and I'm also seeing here Pisces, if it's actually water. So what does your person like and dislike about you? Let's start off with the likes, okay? What they actually like about you is that you're a very hardworking individual, okay? Money is actually very important for you. You wanted to achieve financial security, all right? You have high hopes and dreams for yourself. You're very driven. You're very ambitious, okay? And at the same time, you're also very, very confident with what you're currently doing. That's what they like about you. You're also very patient, especially when it comes to achieving your dreams or your goals. They also like the fact some of you guys love traveling. So they also like that you like to travel, you like to explore, you have this thirst for knowledge as well. You have some thirst to experience new things, new possibilities, okay? That's what they like about you. They also like the fact they are very smart. You're very intellectual with the High Priestess here. I'm going to read it intuitively because I'm drawn to the owl. An owl is all about wisdom, okay? So you're a person who's very wise. You have a lot of knowledge, okay? You're very intellectual or you're very smart. And you're also confident, okay? Just like what I said, you're very confident with what you're currently doing, with who you are. You're also very go-getter, okay? And also picking up that for others of you, you are also a psychic. That's also what I'm hearing, that you are very intuitive as well. You're actually a person with a lot of skills, a lot of talents or gifts. And that's what they like about you. What they don't like about you, okay, let's now proceed to that, is that sometimes it can be very, very secretive. All right. So maybe your person sometimes is going to ask you something. All right. And then you're actually not going to be very direct about it. All right. So I'm actually picking up that sometimes you tend to be a little bit secretive, or it's hard to figure you out. Or perhaps when you're actually mad about something, when your partner asks you or this person asks you, how are you doing? Are you okay? And you're just going to say, I'm good. But they can actually sense as well that you're not, okay? That's what they don't like about you. Sometimes as well, they find you a little bit, you know, snappish or very crabby. That's actually what I'm hearing right now. So you have some moods, okay? Mood swings. That's also what I'm hearing. Another thing that they don't like about you is that you're very much in your pride or ego. That's really what I'm hearing. Five of Swords is all about clash of wills or clash of ego. So when you guys are actually in an argument with each other, all right, it's like you don't want to back down. It's like, I will have the last say, or you're just not going to allow yourself to be defeated, okay? Some of you guys, you don't like to be the first one to apologize. So again, it's pride or ego. That's also what I'm picking up from this person that I'm hearing right now, okay? That's what they don't like about you. But other than that, more positive things, okay? They see you as somebody who's very patient as well. You also have a very sharp memory, okay? That's what they like about you. You really remember things, okay? Dates and everything, they like that. And they like how, you know, wise you are. That you're really, really intellectual, or you're very, very logical and smart. You're also very practical when it comes to decision making. That's also what they like about you. But when you guys are in an argument, oh gosh, okay, that's what they don't like, because what this person, I don't know who is this, but what this person kept on saying is that you always wanted to be the winner in the argument, okay? Like, you would always bring up something that would kind of like, you know, give yourself the upper hand. That's really what I'm hearing right now. Either you're going to bring up the past, okay, so that you will win the argument. That's actually what I'm hearing. Okay, I'm not hearing anything else. Let's see what else. Very interesting. What does your person like and dislike about group number two? Ooh, you got a leg up. You have round and round. Okay, all right. Interesting. And he got here regeneration. Okay, all right. So, what does your person like and dislike about you? What I'm actually picking up very strongly is that your person likes the fact that you're really strong. You're very powerful, okay? Also getting some of you guys are dealing with a person who's either younger or older than you, or somebody is actually younger and somebody's a lot more older than the other, okay? So I'm actually picking up, if this is actually you, who's the older, you know, individual, what your person likes about you is that you are very strong, okay? You are very much like a leader. You take the lead, okay? Because you're a lot more experienced. That's what they like about you. What they actually do not like is that sometimes they feel small. And I feel it's not just about you. It's how they feel, because you know more than them, or that you are probably the one who's actually kind of like leading the relationship, okay? That's actually what I'm hearing right now. And sometimes they feel as if, you know, they're small, or that you are always in control of everything, and that's what they don't like, okay? I'm also picking up that for those of you who's younger, okay, and this person's older, I'm actually getting that sometimes they, you know, feel that you can be a little bit, you know, naive or childish or a little bit immature, okay? When you want something, you want it now. That's also what I'm hearing, okay? Don't shoot the messenger. I'm just going to deliver the messages I'm hearing, okay? But for a lot of you, they really see you as a good support, all right? They love the teamwork between the both of you, okay? That even though you might be different in some ways, you guys balance each other out and you help each other out, okay? Which is very good, because in any type of relationship or partnership, you know, working together as one is very, very important, okay? So that's what they like about you. What they don't like about you as well, sometimes, again, for others of you, you are resistant to changes, okay? That's also what I'm hearing, and that there's that never-ending drama that kept on going on and on and on between the both of you. Maybe that's also the reason why some of you guys already ended things with this person, or the relationship didn't last, because there's that never-ending cycle, those drama. That's what I'm actually hearing very strongly. I'm also picking up that what they also like about you is that they see you as somebody who's actually, again, very determined, that even if things are kind of like already hopeless, you still keep on going forward. You still have high hopes that this would still work, all right? You're very persistent. That's actually what they like about you. The number 7 kept on popping up, guys, so maybe that's going to be of significance for some of you. And 7 is a very spiritual number, okay? So let's see. What else? What does your person like and dislike about group number 2? Okay, you got temptation. Wow, you got love begins. Beautiful. You have balance. Okay. All right. So I'm actually getting strong Capricorn and Libra energy. So somebody here watching is a Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, or Libra. So what do they like and dislike about you? Let's actually put our focus again on the likes, okay? What they like about you is that, again, you're very hardworking. That's really what I'm hearing over and over again. You're very career focused, you're career driven, or you're very ambitious, okay? You're very loyal to your career, to your, or very dedicated to achieve success. That's actually what they really like about you. They also like the fact that you're very seductive. That's actually what I'm hearing, okay? They find you so, so sensual and very seductive, very attractive. For others of you, you might be in a third party. That's actually what I'm hearing right now. And they see you as a temptation, okay? You have this very, very seductive energy about you, oozing with sexual appeal. That's actually what they really, really like about you. And I feel that this person is kind of like saying, it's hard to let you go. It's hard to get you out of my mind. It's kind of like either good or bad for them. Okay. That's what I'm hearing right now. Another thing that they like about you is that, again, you're very generous. You're very, very loving, not only loving of yourself, because you're very confident and you love yourself as well, but you're also very, very loving and generous to the people around you, especially your family, your immediate family, or your close friends, okay? You have a lot of love to give. That's actually what they like about you. You're also very balanced. You're very fair as well. I'm also hearing that you are very objective, okay? You're very objective. What they don't like about you, okay? So I'm actually getting a lot of messages now. Only take what resonates, okay? Not everything will resonate with you guys because this is a general reading. I'm hearing jealousy, okay? So what they don't like about you is that you tend to become overly jealous and very possessive. That's what they don't like about you. Some of them felt restricted or they felt as if smothered, okay? Yes, you're very loving, but sometimes they felt so smothered by, you know, the love that you're giving, all right, or how you're demonstrating your love. And sometimes you're overprotective. That's also what they don't like about you. They also don't like the fact that sometimes you're all over the place. That's also what I'm hearing. You're all over the place. When you're overwhelmed, you're all over the place. Another message I'm hearing from Spirit right now is that what they also don't like about you is that because you are also very busy, okay, with something, either you're busy with your job, maybe you've been doing a lot of, you know, jobs, you may have more than one job or multiple jobs. What they don't like about you is that you're struggling with balance, okay, with this balance card. It's hard for you to cope up with it, okay, and then you get easily, you know, kind of like flustered, or because I'm hearing somebody saying when you're mad or upset or when you're actually stressed out, you tend to snap and really, you know, become this very crabby person. And that's what they don't like about you. Somebody needed to hear that, okay? But all in all, they just love how loving you are and nurturing you are, how generous you are. What they just don't like is sometimes you tend to become a bit overly jealous or possessive, okay? So, yeah. Let's see, what else? Oh boy, a lot of information for group number two. Let's see, what else? What does your person like and dislike about you? See here, you got landscapes, places. Oh my gosh, control. There you go. Oh boy, okay. At the bottom of the deck, you have your prosperity, okay? I love how everything is matching. Okay, let's start off with landscapes and places. So just like what I said at the very beginning of the reading, I actually heard it very strongly. Some of you guys love to travel. If you can remember what I said at the very beginning, now you got landscapes and places. So you may have visited a lot of cities, a lot of countries, or you just basically love adventure or traveling. That's what they like about you, okay? That you're also open to explore new experiences, new opportunities, new perspectives. And being with you is never boring. That's actually what I'm hearing right now. That's what they like about you. They also like the fact that you're very ambitious, just like what I said earlier with this prosperity card. Material wealth or money as well is very, very important for you. So you do everything basically to achieve financial success. You wanted to achieve financial security as well. That's what they like about you, all right? And you're also very beautiful. Whether you're male or female watching this, because I'm drawn to this woman in the mirror, all right? She looks so pretty. She looks so beautiful. She looks so classy and sophisticated. So I feel as well that this person also likes how sophisticated you look or how you carry yourself. You're very fashionable. You're very classy and elegant. That's what they like about you. And you're also very, very powerful as well. You might be born in the year of the dragon because I'm also drawn to the dragon over here, okay? And I notice you keep on getting number 8. So this is 35 and you got 8. So 8 is all about abundance as well. Okay. Another thing that they also like about you is that You know how to be grateful for all of the things they currently have. And that is actually the secret to achieving or attracting more success and abundance in your life. You have to be grateful first, because if you keep on putting on your focus on the things that you don't have, you cannot attract abundance or more things to come, because you already don't, you know, have this ability to be thankful for what you currently have. So with you, that's what they like about you. You know how to appreciate for what it is that you currently have. All right. You're very grateful. That's what they like about you. What they don't like about you. Now here's the thing, and everything is matching, because this surrender card is actually talking about control. And, you know, you always want it to be right. You know, especially when it comes to arguments. Let me go back to one of your cards at the very beginning. Remember, I was talking about the Five of Swords. This is about clash of wills, clash of egos. And whenever you guys get into a heated argument, it's like nobody wanted to back down. And that's what they don't like about you. You always wanted to be right in every argument. That's what they don't like. Because it says here on the surrender card is give up the fight to control others and situations. So there's something about control. And then it says here, relinquish your need to be right. So again, everything is matching. That's actually what they don't like about you. Okay? All right, let's see what else. Let's try this deck. What does your person like and dislike about you? Group number two. You have receptivity. Okay. You have honor the masculine. Okay. Oh, I'm getting a very strong message right now with those two cards. Okay. All right. And you got your sisterhood. Okay, very nice. All right, so the message I'm hearing very strongly, especially with those two cards, what I actually heard from Spirit very strongly, what they don't like about you is that you have strong masculine energies. So especially if you're a woman watching this, you're more of the doer in the relationship. Just like what I said earlier when I actually saw the mama bear and the baby bear. So I'm actually getting, it's like you always take the lead. You always want it to be in control. I love how everything is matching. So what they don't like about it is that it's like you always take the lead. It's like you don't give them a chance to do their part as the masculine. Okay? So this is very, very strong. You guys needed to hear that, especially if you're a woman watching this. You're more in the masculine energy. So there's a lack of balance now. Now, that is actually making sense why I heard something about lack of balance. Because maybe you're always the one who's doing everything in the relationship. Okay? You're deciding everything. You're actually in control of everything without realizing that you're not giving an opportunity or a room for the divine masculine or for the masculine to do his role. Okay? So maybe that's something that you need to contemplate or to, yeah, work on. You have to be more in the receiving energy, especially if you're a woman watching this, because you got receptivity, all right? It's about time to receive and allow your masculine to be the one to give to you, to be doing his role. That's actually what I'm getting, okay? For others of you, I'm going to read it intuitively. What your person likes about you is that you're, again, you're very giving. You're very generous, all right? You're very thoughtful as well. You love to give prizes, maybe gifts, you know, to them or to the people around you. They also like your tattoo. So maybe some of you guys watching this, you have tattoo. They really like that. They find that so freaking cool. They also like the fact that, you know, you are very fashionable. I don't know why I'm hearing fashion. They love your sense of fashion, or you're very original. Okay. That's also what they like about you. And then another thing that they like about you with the sisterhood card is that you guys are like friends at the same time. Not only lovers, but also friends. You're also a good friend. That's also what they like about you. They see you as an ally, okay? It's like you guys are partners in crime. That's what they like about you, all right? They love your loyalty. They love the joy that you bring into their life, all right? You guys are very compatible according to them. They love how they resonate so much with you, okay? All right, so yeah, very interesting. Let's see what else. What does your person like and dislike about you? Group number two. Ooh, community. All right. I don't know. Keep on getting three friends or three people. Either this is also third party for others of you, or maybe you guys are friends as well and not yet lovers. Yeah, movement. You have here internet. Okay. You have amethyst. You have released the dark wound, let love live. You have deception. I'll just get one more. You really keep on getting the number seven, guys. The number seven kept on popping for group number two. So pay attention to that. You have guardian angel. Wow. Okay, I'm actually hearing a lot of messages. Let's start off with the likes, okay? What they actually like about you is that, first and foremost, they love the fact that you are very sociable as well for others of you. You know how to get along with different types of people. You're like a social butterfly. You're very friendly as well. That's what they like about you. They also like the fact that you're never stuck or you don't want to be in a very routinary situation as well. That's also what I'm hearing. You get easily bored when there's no fun, you know? You wanted something that is actually something new, basically. Like, you don't want to be doing the same things over and over again. So they see you as somebody who's actually also very versatile or very diverse. That's what they like about you. And they also like the fact that you are actually, you know, very confident, because this amethyst card is also about confidence, and that you are the type of a person who's willing to transform. You're willing to grow. You're willing to expand. You're ready to evolve and to let go of some things that are actually not good for you anymore, okay? But for others of you, I'm hearing it the opposite way. Some of you are actually, you know, having a hard time, or you're struggling and letting go of something that is not good for you. You keep on dwelling in the past as well. That's also what I'm hearing for a small portion of you. I'm also getting third party. All right. So that's why I said, I noticed there's always three people in every card that I'm going to pull up for you. So maybe this is a sign from spirit that others of you watching group number two are in a triangular relationship. Okay. So I'm actually picking up that. What they also like about you is that, again, you are very patient. Some of you guys are actually still waiting on this person, okay? That's what they like about you. But they are also telling me that for others of you with this deception card, they're kind of like telling me right now that what they don't like about you is that sometimes you just tend to hide everything to yourself. When you're hurt, okay, when you're actually very upset or angry, you tend to retreat, or you tend to just show to everybody that you're okay, but in fact, you're actually not, okay? That's for others of you. You tend to pretend as if I'm good, I'm okay, but the truth is there's a lot going on inside. For others of you, you probably met this person through the internet, okay, through the internet. So either you started dating online, or it's an online app. That's actually what I'm hearing right now. And I'm also picking up, you know, that they see you as just like an angel, all right? They find you so beautiful, so angelic, all right? That's also what they like about you. You've supported this person. That's actually what I'm hearing. You're always there. It's like this lady. There's always someone behind her. And so that's what they like about you as well. You're very supportive to this person. You give them a lot of motivation as well. That's also what they like. Yeah, more likes than dislikes, so don't worry. But yeah, that's actually what I have for you, group number two. Very interesting reading. But before we wrap things up, I'm going to get a random message for you, okay? All right, let's try to pull up the Spirit Oracle deck. This is not going to resonate for all of you, obviously, but somebody needed to share some message, so I decided to pull up one. All right, let's see here. Message for group number two. Okay, you got positive outcome. All right, let's read that. And it says here, there is hope. Don't give up now. Have faith, trust. The forces of love are at work behind the scenes. Oh my gosh. Expect a joyous and positive outcome. Oh my gosh. So there you go. That's the random message for you guys. Group number two. I hope you enjoyed this reading. And I will see you again on the next Pick a Card. Love and light, everyone. Bye-bye. And the last group, we chose Celestite. So let's find out. What does your person like and dislike about you? Spirit guides, archangels, and angels, please provide some guided messages for the collective who chose group number three. Okay, let's see here. You have Queen of Cups. You have Page of Pentacles, Strength. You have the Hangman. You have Five of Pentacles. And then he got here Four of Pentacles. At the bottom of the deck, you have here Four of Cups. Okay, I'm actually seeing a lot of water energy, Scorpio, Pisces, Cancer, especially Pisces, and a lot of Earth as well, Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus, and Leo if it's actually fire. So what does your person like and dislike about you? Let's put our focus on the likes, okay, first. So what they like about you is that you're very sensitive to the emotions of the people around you. You might be an empath as well, all right? You're very loving, you're very sensitive, nurturing. And at the same time, what they like about you is that you love to learn. Okay, you are very wise. You like to actually learn new things. You're open to learning new things. You're very flexible, okay? What they actually do not like about you, though, is that you can be a little bit, you know, secretive. Because Pisces, that's also the energy I'm getting, that you can be a little bit closed off, all right? Just like with this Four of Cups over here. Just look at that crab, or rather that shell over there. And it's like you're going to retreat. You're very secretive when you're hurt, okay? So if they're actually trying to ask you, for instance, how are you doing? Are you okay? You would actually say that you're good, or that sometimes you would give them the silent treatment. That's also what I'm hearing very strongly. That's what they don't like about you. Whenever you get into an argument, that you tend to be closed off, or you tend to retreat back into your shell, or basically you're just going to give them the silent treatment. That's actually what I'm hearing. I'm also getting that what they don't like about you, sometimes you get overly emotional as well. That's also what I'm hearing for others of you. But for others of you, what they like about you is that you are also a bit mature with how you handle the situation. Whenever you are in an argument, you tend to see things from a different perspective, or you're open to hearing the other person out. So I'm getting different energies here, okay? We need to take what resonates, because I'm actually getting different scenarios, different personalities, or energies, basically. And then another thing that they like about you is that you are a very strong person, okay, with this strength card over here. You probably dealt with a lot of, you know, hardships in life or a lot of failures, but you just keep on going forward. That's also what they like about you. You remain strong and positive. That's also what they like about you. You never saw yourself as a victim, but for others of you, again, what I'm hearing is that sometimes you also tend to see yourself as a victim. That's also what I'm picking up for others of you. So only take what resonates, because I'm getting, you know, different energies here. When you're actually, you know, really upset, or when you're down in the dumps, you're actually not seeing things from a higher perspective. You always just put your focus on the things that you actually do not have. That's also what they don't like about you. Sometimes you're also quite stubborn. That's also what I'm hearing. That's what they don't like about you. You're not also open to seeing things for what they are. All right. You're just putting your focus on the negative side of things. That's also what I'm getting for others of you. Okay. Don't shoot the messenger. I'm just actually delivering the messages I'm hearing right now. But yeah, I'm also picking up that what they also like about you, just like what I said, they love the fact that you wanted to try out something new. You don't want things that are so boring, okay? You get easily bored if you are actually doing something that is very routinary. So they love the fact that you're open to learning new things, new stuff, something new, okay? But when you're actually mad or upset, what I'm hearing right now from Spirit as well, is that your person doesn't like it when you're very closed off, just like the shell. You're going to be, you know, very closed off, and it's hard to get those emotions sometimes outside, or you don't want to open up. That's also what I'm hearing for others of you, okay? I'm also hearing what they also like about you is that you're very, very intuitive, okay? Again, you're sensitive to the emotions and feelings of others as well. This can also be a downside for others of you. They also don't like the fact that you're overly sensitive. So again, only take what resonates, all right? And just leave the rest. Let's try to pull up more. What does your person like and dislike about you? You have Treasure Island. You have Clean It Up. Oh, wow. You got the Tribe. Okay. All right. Interesting. So, what they actually like about you is that you know how to value the people around you, okay? You can be a very, very good friend with the Tribe over here. You're very supportive. You're actually very loving, and also you know how to basically treasure, all right, the people that are close to you, and you make them feel appreciated. You make them feel very special and loved. So that's what they actually like about you. I'm also hearing they love the fact that you're very sentimental. Okay, they love the fact that you would always remember the first time, let's say, that you guys dated, or you still kept some things. That's actually what I'm hearing. You kept some things that would actually remind you and your person's first date, let's say. That's just an example, but they love how sentimental you are, all right? You might be actually keeping, you know, some things that would actually be of significance for you with regards to a person, because I'm actually drawn to the treasure chest. So yeah, that's what they like about you. Some of you guys, you are very patient, okay? You're very patient in achieving your goals. You might be slow, but it doesn't matter, all right? You just keep on going forward. You're not really in a rush in achieving your goals. That's also what they like about you. And again, you give them a lot of support as well, or you are a very supportive person, very dependable, very reliable, and very nurturing. You might be different, you know, in some ways, because I feel that some of you guys are dealing with either a person who's younger than you or older than you. But regardless, your person is actually saying that they resonate so much with you. Even though you guys are different, you guys actually balance each other out. Maybe one is patient and one is impatient, okay? With this clean it up, I feel, all right, that what they also like about you, you can be very tidy or a neat freak. That's actually what I'm hearing right now. I'm going to read it intuitively and based on what I'm actually hearing. What I actually heard when I saw this card, it's not about the meaning of the card. What actually came out very strongly was that this person is saying you are so neat and tidy, okay? A little bit OCD though. That's also what I'm hearing for others of you, okay? Very much like a neat freak. All right, let's see what else. What does your person like and dislike about you? You have discontent and boredom. Keep on getting the number 4, all right? And then you got shadow, all right? And you have heart chakra. Okay. So what I'm actually picking up here very strongly with the discontent and boredom, I believe I already actually mentioned something about that. If you remember what I said, they like the fact that you are a person who wanted to try out something new. You get easily bored, okay? So when you're actually doing the same things over and over again, you will actually get bored to tears, all right? That's what they like about you, because your person is saying that you wanted to try something new. You're very diverse as well, all right? There's a lot of things that you wanted to try out because you're a person who's thirsty for knowledge. You're actually thirsty to learn new things, okay? So being with you is actually never boring. That's actually what they like about you. What they also like about you is that, again, when you love someone, you really demonstrate it, all right? You really make the person feel special and very much valued. What they don't like about you is that sometimes you tend to be really emotionally sensitive or very emotional. That's actually what I heard right now. Very, way too emotional. You might be a Pisces as well, because I keep on getting Pisces for group number 3, okay? Very sensitive to, you know, or moody. That's really what I'm hearing. Very moody, very crabby. That sometimes when you're upset, when they talk to you, it's like they're talking to a wall. That's actually what I'm hearing. That you tend to be a little bit close off. The more that they try to ask you how you are doing or are you okay, you're just going to give them a cold or silent treatment. That's actually what they don't like about you, okay? They also don't like the fact that you have a lot of fears, Okay, because this card is also talking about fears, or you're afraid to face your inner demons, all right? Or you tend to get really overwhelmed by your fears. Maybe you tend to overanalyze something, or you tend to overthink something, and you get really anxious about that. So there's something about fears for group number three as well. But other than that, when you're actually in love with someone or the people that you truly love, you're very open and giving, and you're very nurturing as well. And you would really make the person feel special and very much valued, okay? So yeah, I notice you really keep on getting the number four. So four talks about stability. So that's also what they like about you, that you're very stable. But the downside to that sometimes, what I'm hearing as well, is that you can be emotionally unstable. Okay? So only take what resonates. What does your person like and dislike about you, group number three? You have here transformation. Okay, and you got here games. And you have house buildings. Okay. So, I usually do not read cards in reverse, but when I actually pulled up that card, I actually heard it from spirit. So I'm going to follow more in what I'm hearing, okay? I don't go by it. It actually came out in reverse, so I'm going to read it in reverse. It depends on what I'm hearing, and at the same time when I look at the card. But it came out in reverse, and that's exactly what I heard, so I'm going to deliver it. What your person did not like about you, let's actually put our focus there first, because that's what I heard instantly, is that you're afraid to take some risk, okay? That's also what they don't like about you. Sometimes you have a lot of fears, like something is holding you back. So I feel that this person I'm channeling is saying that there's a lot of potential, there's a lot of things they can actually do, but sometimes the only person is holding you back is yourself, okay? So I'm hearing that somebody needed to hear that message, and that's what they don't like about you. Because of your fears, you kind of like, you're limiting yourself, basically, and you're afraid to step out of your comfort zone or to take that leap of faith. Some of you guys are still not yet transforming, or you're still not open to changing, okay? You still are very much in your comfort zone, okay? You don't want to change. That's also what I'm hearing for others of you. I'm getting a mixture of energies and scenarios, so only take what resonates, okay? What they also like about you is that, again, you are a person who is actually very skilled and very intellectual as well, and very creative. I'm actually getting a more creative person, artistic, very creative, very talented, whether that's actually drawing, any creative stuff, music, or writing. I don't know. I'm picking that up very strongly. They also like your eyes, by the way. But what they don't like about you is that sometimes you do... Okay, yeah, this is not going to be for all of you, right? And don't shoot the messenger, because again, I'm just going to deliver everything that I'm hearing right now. What I'm hearing, sometimes you do mind games. They don't like that, okay, about you. You do mind games, or you can be a person who, again, who tends to overthink, overanalyze a situation, and that's what they don't like about you. With the house and buildings, what I actually heard very strongly is that, again, you keep your house clean, you're very neat, you're very tidy. There's something about cleanliness or being neat, with group number three, totally a different energy. They really love that about you, that you are a person who's very neat around the house. You're very clean. Everything is sparkling clean, okay? A little bit OCD for others of you. Maybe some of them, they don't like that because it's a little bit OCD. But they really like the fact that you're very neat around the house. You keep everything clean and organized. That's actually what they like about you. I'm also hearing that what they don't like about you is that sometimes when you're actually in a mess, all right, like when you're actually bothered by something, you tend to lose focus. You're just really all over the place. That's actually what they're saying, okay? That's the one thing that they don't like about you as well. Yeah, okay. All right, Spirit is saying it's more on when you're very much overwhelmed by a lot of emotions or when you're upset and mad. Sometimes the logical mind is not working. It's more in the emotions. So there's a lack of balance in the logical mind or your intellect as well as your emotions, okay? I'm hearing this very strongly. Some of them, they're saying what they don't like about you is that you can be a little bit indecisive or fickle-minded. Okay, let's move on. Wow, a lot of messages as well for group number three. Let's see. What does your person like and dislike about you, group number three? Oh my gosh, you got here falling in love. Ooh. Oh my gosh, what did I tell you? Some of you guys are very secretive. Yeah, because earlier you actually got this card. Let me go back to one of your cards. Where is that card? That's weird. Not seeing it anymore. There you go. Yeah, actually got this card. So, just like what I said, you can be a little bit secretive. You're hiding in your shell, okay? And you got a card that talks about secrecy, all right? So, yeah, very interesting how everything is matching. And then you got time and tide as well. So, what they like about you with the falling in love, obviously, you know, they love falling in love with you, okay? Because you give them something so special. It's like, again, you make this person feel so special and loved, okay? You really demonstrate it. Just like what I said earlier, when you love someone, not just your person, you really make the person or the people around you feel very, very special and very much appreciated. And again, they also feel that the connection that they have with you is very spiritual as well. That's also what they actually like about, you know, the connection with you or what they like about you. You give them that different type of love, all right? A different version of love. It's not something just physical. It's something beyond, okay? That's actually what they like about you. They also like the fact that you're, again, there's something about patience as well. Some of you guys, you know, they really like the fact they're very, very patient. Some of you guys have been waiting, you know, for this person as well. And some of them, they're aware that you're waiting, okay? And I'm also hearing loyalty very, very strongly. So they love the fact that you're very loyal to them and you are very patient, you know, when it comes to them. You're patient with their ways, their behavior, okay? I'm also hearing right now that what they don't like about you is that, again, you can be a little bit guarded, okay? Just like the shell. You know, when you're hurt, you tend to retreat to your shell, okay? You're very guarded. You're very protective of yourself. And sometimes you are very secretive. It's like, it's so hard to figure you out. And I'm hearing some of you guys, you tend to give them the cold shoulder or the silent treatment. All right. That's actually, you know, what they don't like about you. You may have reddish brown hair, because I notice you keep on getting a lot of cards with women with reddish brown hair, or there's something about the hair as well. And you may have tattoos, so maybe, yeah, they love your tattoos. They also like that about you. Yeah, I'm not hearing anything else. Okay, let's try to move on to the next. What your person like and dislike about you. All right, you got here, shapeshifter. Wow, you got Pioneer. Okay. You have Athlete. And you have Teacher. Okay. Nice. So, let's start off with Shapeshifter. What they actually like about you is that you have the ability basically to see the potential in everything. And at the same time, you're like a chameleon. You can easily adapt to any type of environment or adapt to changes. Or you have the ability to blend with people, different types of personalities, okay? That's actually what they like about you. They also like the fact that you're very smart, just like what I said. Even at the very beginning, I actually mentioned that you're actually very smart and more on the creative side as well. That's also what I'm picking up. You're very original. You have a lot of ideas. You're very creative, just like what I said. You can actually come up with things that nobody has come up before or nobody has actually thought about before. And you're very original, okay? That's actually what they like about you. They also like the fact that you take good care of your body. You may have a very good, you know, body. Either you also hit the gym. That's also what they like about you. You're very health conscious as well. Or you're just very, very strong, okay? You have this strength of spirit. That's also what they like about you. They also like the fact that you're very knowledgeable, you're very wise, you have a lot of experience, and you also love to share, okay? You love to share those experiences, or you share those knowledge, okay, to others. But again, like what I said, you're very skillful and very talented. There's a lot of things that you can actually do. You have a lot of ideas, and some of you, what I'm hearing, is that somebody's saying, like, there's a lot of things they can do, but why is it they can't see that for yourself? Why do you keep on seeing yourself as if you don't have this or you don't have that? I don't know. I keep on hearing that. So somebody also needed to hear that, all right? Because this person is actually saying that you fail to see, you know, yourself differently, all right? You always look at the, you know, not so good things, or you're actually not seeing that there's a lot of things that you can still do, because this person is saying, I believe in your potential. I believe in what you can actually do. But what I don't like about you is that you're not seeing it. You always, you know, see yourself differently. I don't know. Somebody needed to hear that. Okay, let's move on. Try this duck. What does your person like and dislike about you? Group number 3. Oh, wow. You guys are very caring. Caring connections. Caring and nurturing. Oh, wow. Okay. Well, we've already discussed that earlier, that they really see you as a very loving person, very caring, very nurturing. You might be also Cancer or Pisces. I don't know. I'm hearing that very strongly right now. Elevator. Sacred Journey. Healing. Oh, wow. Okay. And you got, this could be the one. Hold on, I just need to drink some water. Okay, hold on. All right, sorry about that. I need to drink some water. Okay, so going back to your cards, what your person likes about you, you're very caring. You're very nurturing, okay? And we've already discussed that they find you so loving, so nurturing. You give them this different version of love, okay, that they've never felt as well, just like what I mentioned earlier. They also like the fact that you have this healing vibe about you. You make them feel at peace. You have this very, you know, soothing vibe. Maybe your voice as well, calming. Something calming. That's really what I'm hearing right now. You might be also a healer watching this or doing some energy healing. That's also what I'm picking up. They also like the fact that you're very family-oriented, okay? You're very family-oriented. You really value your family. You respect your family so much. Or you have big hopes as well, not only for yourself, but your family. And you're also very idealistic when it comes to romance, okay? You're very romantic. That's actually what I'm getting, very dreamy. I'm also getting here that what they also like about you is that you're also able to rise above, you know, any negative experiences, okay? Some of you are very optimistic and just really rising above from anything that is heavy. You're open to transforming. You're open to changes. However, for others of you, what I'm hearing, it's the opposite, really. Because remember, this is a general reading, different personalities, different energies. What I'm also hearing for others of you is that you're actually having a hard time, like you're struggling, you know, rising above from any difficult situation. Sometimes you tend to go back and just feel this lack. That's actually what I'm getting. That's why I heard somebody actually saying, like, why can't you see, you know, things differently? Or how you also see yourself, your potential, your skills. That's also what I'm hearing very strongly right now. So only take what resonates, okay? But all in all, this person, you know, is really saying how loving you are, how caring you are. You may have very beautiful eyes. I don't know. You may have dreamy eyes, very hypnotic. That's actually what I'm hearing right now. So I'm just going to deliver what I'm hearing. And again, they just love how you are very much family oriented, okay, that you take good care of your family as well as your own family. If you're already a mother, let's say, or a dad, they love that about you. Okay, so there you go. That's actually what I have for group number 3. But before I wrap things up, I'm going to pull up a random message for you guys. So obviously, not everybody will resonate with this message, but somebody needed to hear it. Let's see. Message for group number 3, Spirit. Okay. Well, you got 2 cards. Interesting. Let's start off with innocence. And it says here, innocence, purity, joy. You're being encouraged to just be you. Be a shining light for the world. Expect positive outcome to flow from your honesty and pure intentions. Beautiful. Another message for you, group number 3, responsibility. And it says here, do what feels right for you above all else. It is impossible to please all parties in the present situation. You have responsibility only for your own life and actions. Others must take responsibility for themselves. house. Okay, so those are the messages. Some of you guys will definitely resonate with these two messages. It's just random. It's something that I just wanted to pull up before we wrap things up, okay? But anyway, I hope you enjoyed this reading, and I will see you again on the next Pick a Card. Bye-bye, guys. Love and light.